and lots of developments to get to from the province today. We'll start with one of the Premier's own members facing backlash for not following his government's rules. Conservative MPP Sam Oosterhoff posted photos on Facebook last night posing with at least 40 people with no masks or physical distancing. There are certainly photos we don't come across often during the pandemic. Large groups posing closely together without masks.
I think it was shocking. I think it was inappropriate. And I think that there definitely needs to be consequences for Mr. Oosterhoff.
Sam Oosterhoff is a Conservative MPP for Niagara West and also serves as parliamentary assistant to the education minister. On Sunday night, he posted photos of what appeared to be a large family gathering. After facing criticism, he posted an explanation, writing this was an event at a staffed banquet hall with under 50 people within the rules. He later apologized for not wearing a mask during what he called a quick pick.
It's really shameful. The fact that this fellow is simply doesn't think that it's necessary to put on a mask and he can hang out with 40 different people is really, really troubling. And
the head of the Ontario Hospital Association is calling for his resignation, but the premier defending his member.
I have 100% confidence in Sam. He came out and apologized. Hey, guys, everyone makes mistakes.
He wasn't the only one facing calls for resignation today.
If she will not do the right thing and resign, Mr. The Premier Order. Of Ontario needs to fire his Minister of Long...
The opposition leader urging Long-Term Care Minister Marilee Fullerton to step down after an independent commission found long-term care homes were forgotten in the initial provincial plans to control the spread of the virus until residents started dying.
Somebody has to take responsibility for all of those deaths.
Please don't make it about me. I want it to be about Ontarians.
Meantime, the Premier was bombarded with questions today about why he didn't place additional restrictions on Halton and Durham, two regions seeing high case counts. The decision comes the day after Halton Region politicians wrote an open letter to Chief Medical Officer of Health, Dr. David Williams, asking him not to impose blanket measures on the region.
Elected officials have always had a say. Every single time we go back to stage two, I've contacted all the mayors. I speak to them, and everyone was in consensus. But when they aren't, it's concerning to me. And a priority is to keep the economy going, protect the small businesses.
With the economy in mind, the finance minister announcing the provincial budget will be tabled on November 5th.
It will be a three-year budget that will build on our government's $30 billion response to COVID-19.
And there were questions today about whether or not the modified stage two restrictions are even working, given the fact that we are seeing record high numbers here. The health minister said today the province is seeing the impacts of Thanksgiving weekend, which is adding to community transmissions. Because of that, they're not seeing numbers come down as quickly as they'd like, but some regions like Ottawa are seeing improvements.